Good evening, everybody. I know the Twin Cities got some applause for hosting the Super Bowl and all that, but this is some next level stuff. As a fashion writer for Forbes magazine calls the Twin Cities the hottest retail market in the country. So let me go ahead and brush that dirt off real quick. Fifth Avenue. Rodeo Drive. Washington Avenue. We're talking about this Washington. So Forbes magazine calls this North Loop retailer, quote, the hottest retailer in the Minneapolis-St. Paul Twin Cities, which is arguably the hottest place for innovative new retail concepts. Okay.
It was a big headline. I don't know, it was kind of like a little bit of like, whoa, like we've kind of made our mark.
Greg Walsh founded Martin Patrick III on men's accessories at the rock bottom of the recession in 2008. Figure that.
Pocket squares, ties, briefcases,
eyeglasses. That's where you started, huh?
Yeah.
Then they added clothing, then interior design, and art, and fragrances, and jewelry, and a barber shop, and a bar. Each room its own boutique of high-end lifestyle, tailored for men.
It kind of rolls from space to space. It's not like a lot of other stores where you walk in and you can kind of see the whole thing. I mean, there's a discovery about it.
What started as a 1,000 square foot store is now on its fifth expansion.
So we have 17,000 square feet now, and then we'll be at 22,000 when we...
And you blow out another wall.
Blow out another wall.
According to a recent Fast Company article, Martin Patrick III has grown by at least 40% in sales every year. As for the hottest retail market in the country claim in Forbes, writer Pam Danziger points to Nicollet Mall and the North Loop, other shops like Asgov Finlayson and Denolo that offer local retail in a way that online stores cannot. They are, in a sense, bringing folks back to brick and mortar, according to the article.
How do you compete with something like Amazon that has crushed so many a store like this?
We used to do e-commerce, and we probably about 9 months ago just shut it all down.
Why?
Because we do brick and mortar really well, and we did e-commerce horribly. And it's just a competitive, our store is about being here, the experience, the staff we have that are highly educated on all the product. And just the personal service and attention to it.
Walsh says, out with the same old, same old. This is local, this is cool, this is quality, with a kiss of Minnesota nice. Brick and mortar is not dead, it is being refined, and others are noticing.
But it's not all roses, rainbows, and luxury scents in the North Loop. It can also be a tough market. Filson and Shinola closed up and headed for the Galleria and Edina, Foundry Home Goods, Kid and Ace, Loco Delish. They've all closed or moved in the last few years.